Welcome back, class 10, your civics revision class. Today, I will just discuss some questions from all over. All over your syllabus. Suppose, let me see. Which house of the Union Legislature has absolute power on money bill? The Lok Sabha. How many persons may the President of India nominate as members of the Rajya Sabha, and what qualifications, if any, should they possess for nomination to the Rajya Sabha? The President can nominate 12 members. They are nominated by the President from among the persons having special knowledge or practical experience in the subjects or matters such as literature, science, art and social service. Then a question is, what is question hour? The first hour on every working day of the house is reserved for question unless otherwise decided by the speaker. Now, please remember, all the motions are important. Adjournment motion, no confidence motion. Impeachment is important. Question hour, universal adult franchise, these terms you should know. Mention three component parts of the union executive: president, vice president, prime minister. Name the chief executive in India. Why is he elected indirectly? President is the chief executive in India. He is indirectly elected because a direct election would involve tremendous work and heavy expenditure, and he, being a constitutional head, ought to be elected indirectly, as directly elected members cannot become the constitutional head. Qualifications of the President. Who is the first citizen of India? The President is the first citizen of India. When and how can the President of India be removed from office? The President can be removed from his office for violation of Constitution by the method known as impeachment. By what majority is the impeachment resolution passed? The impeachment resolution must be passed by 2/3 of the total majority. Mention two reasons for adopting the indirect method that we have discussed. Who administers oath of office to the President? The Chief Justice of India. I'm just randomly going through for a quick revision from all the chapters. What is President's limited veto power? A bill passed by the Parliament requires President's assent, A-S-S-E-N-T, that means signature, to become a law. He may refuse to give assent and send it back for reconsideration. If the bill is again passed by the President, with or without the amendments, the President will have to give his assent to it this time. When can the President issue an ordinance? The President can issue an ordinance when the President is satisfied that immediate necessary legislative action is required, and Parliament is not in session. Okay. Write any one circumstances when the President can declare national emergency. National emergency can be declared if there is war, external aggression, or armed rebellion inside the country. Who is the ex officio chairperson of Rajya Sabha? The Vice President is the ex officio chairperson of Rajya Sabha. Mention one difference in the election of the Vice President and that of the President of India so far as the electorate is concerned. The state legislature have no hand in election of the Vice President. Both the Houses of the Parliament sitting together elect the Vice President, whereas the President is elected by the Electoral College. Then, who settles the dispute in connection with the election of the President of India? The Supreme Court settles the dispute. These type of questions, short questions, might come. Who appoints the Prime Minister? The Prime Minister is appointed by the President. The President invites only that person to be the Prime Minister who is the leader of the single majority party of the Lok Sabha. When no single party gets a majority, the President may invite the leader of the combination of the parties constituting majority in the Lok Sabha. Who is the constitutional head of the Union Government? The Prime Minister. The Chief Executive is the President and the constitutional head is the Prime Minister. Under what provision can a non-member of the Parliament be made a minister? Yes, a non-member can be made appointed, can be appointed as a minister, but he has to be elected or nominated to the Parliament within 6 months from his appointment. Okay, let me find some ICSC questions. Okay. By whom and on whose advice is the Council of Ministers appointed? The Council of Ministers is appointed by the President on the advice of the Prime Minister. Mention one way by which the authority of the Prime Minister can be checked. The authority of the Prime Minister can be checked by the Cabinet or by the Parliament or by the opposition party. What happens when a motion of no confidence is passed against the minister? The minister has to resign. Okay. Now from the judiciary. Who determines the strength of the Supreme Court? The strength of the Supreme Court is decided by the Parliament. Besides being a citizen of India, what are the legal and judicial qualifications of a judge of the Supreme Court? The judge must have been a judge for one or more high courts for consecutive 5 years, or should be an advocate of one or more high courts for consecutive 10 years, or should be a distinguished jurist in the opinion of the President. Randomly, I'm taking. Oh, this is important. What writs can the Supreme Court issue to protect the fundamental rights? The writ of habeas corpus, writ of mandamus, writ of prohibition, writ of quorantur, and writ of certiorari. You have to know all of them. Definition. What is meant by court of record is important. Mention any 2 points or measures to ensure the independence of judiciary. What are the 2 measures? The judges are appointed by the President in consultation with the Chief Justice. And such are the judges. This ensures their independence. And a judge of the Supreme Court or High Court is not allowed to practice law after his or her retirement. Which body has the final authority to interpret the Constitution of India? The Supreme Court of India. Mention one important exclusive function of the Supreme Court to interpret the Constitution. By whom is the Chief Justice of High Court appointed and how it is done? The Chief Justice of High Court is appointed by the President in consultation with the Chief Justice of the Supreme Court and the State Governor. Who administers the oath of office of the High Court? The Judge of the High Court. Who administers the oath of office to the High Court judges? The Governor of the State. And on what ground can the judge of a high court be removed? A judge of a high court can be removed by proven misbehavior. Proven word is the key word. Proven misbehavior or incapacity. Okay. Define high court's power of judicial review. High court exercises power of judicial review to judge the validity of a state law or central law. What is meant by appellate jurisdiction? Appellate jurisdiction means that the High Court has the power to accept appeals against the decision of the High Court, District Court, in civil as well as the criminal matters. So these type of questions are, you know, examples of short questions which I've discussed, because just to give an idea what type of questions are set in your ICSE examination. I hope you've understood this revision class. Thank you for today.